this is Jason with Maya. Today we're going to look at a small journal file to aid in the selection of holes in a particular row. This was by customer request. They had a part that had thousands of holes. This is a much simplified version of the actual customer part. It was a fiber laser multi-axis drilling machine. They planned to use the hole operation where you could easily select the edge of a hole, which works wonderfully. But when you have thousands of holes, it can be tedious. Fence selection proves to be a little risky, if not impossible in some cases. All holes on face would only be useful if you actually split the face adjacent to each row, which is a project in itself. So we thought using class selection would be interesting. With class selection, if we could somehow attribute just the edges of the row that we're interested in, we could refer to it here and have it select all of those for us. So that is exactly what the journal does. We will, I'm going to start with nothing selected. And so nothing in the select set. And if I go to my developer tab, if you don't have a developer tab, you can right click and customize and turn that tab on. I'm going to go ahead and play. And here's my VB.net. This could be C# or Python if you're more comfortable with those languages. And we're just going to run it. There's a little bit of validation that happens in the beginning. The way this is written is that it takes one edge and one face and uses that to determine the adjacent cylinder, and then proceeds to find all the other cylinders in that Z-plane that are the same size. So the only requirement is that we select an edge and a face, and then we run the journal. We'll be prompted for a name for our edges of holes, and the software does all that tedious work for us. So now if we set our select filter to edge, and if we just mouse over an edge, you'll see that in the queue line above that the edge name is row one. And if you go ahead and actually select it and look at the object details, you'll see that certainly row one is the name assigned to that. So now it's very easy work for our drilling operation to select all of those holes. We'll just use select, and we'll use the class selection and specify the name. And there it just instantly selects those edges for us. And then we can do things like optimize, maybe shortest path, and hit okay, and just generate that. So you see very quickly, we can reliably select all the holes we need using a journal in NXCam. And thank you for watching.